morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
This morning we come as the people of faith to celebrate the beautiful, precious gift of life of our brother Lawrence Carlucci, also known as Larry, Dad, father-in-law, grandpa, great-grandpa, uncle, friend, or father-in-law. Let us gather our memories before this altar of God, because that's where he's sick, to receive the Eucharist and nurture his own faith. So this morning, with a grateful heart, we present this gift back to God. And there is yes, sorrow and pain we have. There are some of the family members could not be here because what was going around there. So keep those family members also in your prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. May the Father of mercies, the God of all consolation, be with us as we gather to pray for Lawrence Carlucci and for one another. May the grace of Jesus Christ be with you all and with your spirit. In the words of baptism, Lawrence Carlucci died with Christ 93 years back and rose within to new life. May Larry now share with Jesus eternal glory. Is that like to invite Linda, the husband, Dad, his grandson, his daughter, please come up. We're going to unfold the pall placed over the casket. Is a reminder of the baptismal garment of our brother Lawrence, a sign of his Christian dignity. In baptism, Lawrence received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. Dear family, this morning we come together to renew our trust in Christ Jesus, who by dying on the cross has set us free and by rising the gates of heaven for us. This morning we pray for Lauren that he may share in Christ's victory, and we pray for ourselves. Then we pray for his children, his daughter, Linda, his spouses, grandchildren, their spouses, and great grandchildren, his family and friend, that the good God may grant them the gift of his loving consolation. And so we pray. As we pray for Larry, we remember also his wife. And just like 7-8 months back, we buried his son, Larry Jr. too. So we keep them in our prayers. God of our ancestors in faith, by the covenant made on Mount Sinai, you taught your holy people to strengthen the bonds of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly upon our brother Lawrence, a father, a father-in-law, grandpa, great-grandpa, uncle, friend, who sought to bind his family to you. Bring Larry one day to heavenly home, where the saints dwell in blessedness and peace. We ask this prayer to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd like to invite Larry's niece, Elizabeth Sorzonsky, proclaim our first reading.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. To everything there is a reason. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What profit have workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts, so they cannot find out from beginning to end the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
sent his disciples, and this morning as we gather together as the people of faith to celebrate his precious gift of life. And yet, there is so much pain we have because we have lost someone who was very dear to us, very close to us. And in your pain and in your sorrow, the beautiful, comforting words of Jesus come to us and telling us and reminding us, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I tell you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there also you may be. Where I am going, you know the way. And Thomas, one of his disciples, said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. St. Pius X Parish is truly honored to welcome you all and to offer our greatest prayer, the Holy Mass, for Larry's soul and the consolation of all who know and love him. No short funeral homily can capture the fullness of a person. If I were to preach to you for an hour about his life, afterwards I bet that each of you here could add another unique story. This morning I'm going to reflect upon in just a couple of aspects of Larry's Carlucci's life. Feel that all of you who are his family and friends are already familiar with. He being a man of family, friends, and faith. All of us here at St. Pius X Parish family extend condolences to Larry's family on behalf of pastoral staff, pastoral associates, to these two wonderful ladies assisting and during the Mass, Virginia and Loretta, our music ministry, Terry and Thomas, and also Stephanie Morda brought the Eucharist to your dad once a week, and myself. So we extend our condolences and prayers to his daughter. Is he calling us? I don't think so. His daughter Linda and her husband Doug, daughter-in-law Patricia, his grandchildren Lauren, Natalie, Mary Catherine, James Lawrence, Patricia Rose, and their spouse Jeremy, Frank, Elena, and great-grandson Paige, granddaughter Paige, Catherine, nephews and nieces, relatives and friends. And many could not attend due to this recent surge and outbreak of coronavirus. They all wanted to be here. But right now we live in the reality. So keep those family members not here. And later on they'll be watching this Mass via recording of this Eucharist. All of us here have seen the friends off at airports and other places of departure. As the first thing reminded us, there's a time for everything. Time to born, time to die, time to laugh, time to cry, time to fly the flights and bring them back. I'm sure you, the Carlucci, and the Ort families would have experienced these departures. At times, very sad. When you said goodbye to Larry, on many occasions on his way to in and out of the country. Larry was passionate about building and flying radio model airplanes. So he knew exactly ascending and descending the airborne at the flight moments. He was involved with the Radio Control Society in Marine Park. Gibson Beach Model Airplane Club. Flag of Country Radio Aero Modelers Club in Florida. So I'm sure he had many trips back and forth from airport to airport. When friends are departing, we go with them as far as we are allowed. and linger with them as long as possible. But eventually, we have to let them go. However, before we do so, we bid them goodbye and wish them a safe journey until we meet again. Death is a moment of departure. And we've done it 7 to 8 months back with Larry's son, Larry Jr. And this morning, that's why we are gathered here this morning in this lovely, beautiful decorated for the Christmas season, the church, the cathedral, where Larry was a part of the worshiping community. It is here in this sacred place one would often find Larry praying along with his wife, Dr. Linda, and her late son Larry Jr. We are gathered here to bid our final farewell to our dear brother in Christ Jesus, father, father-in-law, grandfather, great-grandfather, uncle and friend, Larry. We now accompany him to the very threshold of the other world. Through our prayers, we bid him farewell and wish him a safe journey to God's house. During the sacred season of Advent and Christmas, we have heard how just as Mary was forced to give up her only son, just as she had to return to God the Father the great gift of life, he gave her Jesus his son, so too we must learn to return to God a dear parishioner, your loved one, Larry Carlucci. Today we celebrate his sacred memory. Today we remember him as one of the faithful departed. Larry is not just one of the faithful departed from us. He is one of the faithful returned to God, joining his parents, his beloved wife, his son, in God's kingdom. Our faith calls us not only to lament our loss, but to celebrate Larry's gain and to pray for his eternal peace. Our faith does not banish our sense of loss. It is only natural his daughter Linda and husband Douglas, daughter La Patricia, his grandchild Lauren, Natalie, Mary Catherine, James Lawrence, Patricia Rose, and their spouses Jeremy, Frank, and Elena, and great-granddaughter Paige Catherine, and all the family that you feel today a great sense of loss. You, his birth family, were very close to him, and he to you, and we to his St. Pius parish family were close to him, and he to us. Yes, our faith affirms the great truth that all life is a gift from God. Each one of us will have our own special memories of Larry. And I'm sure you have been reliving and retelling many memories, especially since we became aware of his illness, since his death on Thursday, December 23rd at White Oak Tree Rehab Center at Woodbury. I shall attempt to piece together some of those memories shared by family members, especially Linda and husband Doug, who was such a huge support to Larry in his final illness. Memory by Linda, his daughter. My father was a man of very little words. He did not say much, but when he did, all those in his presence would listen. He was a man with a lot of patience. One particular memory I have of my father was when he taught me in Marine Park, Brooklyn, how to fly a kite. We went when we had some time off from a job, which was rare, as he was always working to provide a better life for my brother and I. I treasure those times, and it was just the two of us. He would show me how to hold a string, pay attention to the wind, and would not get upset even when I did it wrong. One day I almost lost my kite, even running after it to catch it for me. The best memories I have of my dad were our Sunday, Saturday afternoon together, which were not as often as I would have liked to do. He would take me out to Freeport, Long Island, to look at the boats along Guy Lombardo Boulevard. I know that road. My father had a boat when Larry and I were younger, but life got in a way and he had to sell it. I used to walk with him and we would pick out the next boat that one day he would buy. I always look forward to those Saturday afternoons. Yes, I will miss him. He was very much a part of my life. Linda also said, her father's biggest joy in life was his grandchildren. He loved being a grams, enjoyed fishing, loved biscotti, and of course the pasta, and spending time with his family. His daughter, Linda Patricia, she writes, Larry was a hardworking, dedicated family man. He enjoyed the simple pleasures in life, growing figs and tomatoes in the backyard of his home in Brooklyn. A good Frank Sinatra song, and of course a glass of scotch neat. He loved being a grand to his three grandchildren. They have such a happy memories of him while they were growing up. Going to Floyd Bennett Airfield to watch him fly his radio control planes. Fishing off the captain rod at Cape Tree, opening presents together on Christmas morning. While we mourn for him, we must remember that he's released from his earthly suffering and is in the paradise with all those he knew and loved in this life. We should always take the comfort in that thought. Thank you, Larry, again for your many kindnesses. Senator Doug writes, Larry was a father-in-law extraordinary. Always had your back. Provided sound advice. Only when asked. He asked for very little. Biscotti pasta. Special ravioli. And his daily, sometimes two wine spritzers. He was a model airplane builder and flyer, winning many awards. I remember asking him to build a biplane for me. He said no until one was sitting on the dining room table for my birthday. He loved his family, his wife Rosita, son Larry Jr., daughter LaPat, and his grandchildren, Mary James, Trisha, and Lauren, his daughter Linda, but most importantly, I knew he loved me. He lived an excellent life. I repeat, a father-in-law extraordinary. His oldest granddaughter, Mary, writes, my grandpa was a devoted family man. He took his role as a patriarch very seriously. I recall he always carried himself in a very stoic manner, which I now appreciate as an adult as his way of protecting and caring for all that of us. He worked very, very hard his whole life to make sure his family prospered. My oldest memory as a child of seeing him break from his shell are when we visited Coleman Street and toured his infamous tomato fig garden and the several visits to large field with my dad to watch Grant fly the model planes he had built. In both instances, I recall feeling so excited like I was visiting a magical place. Gramps was very passionate about his hobbies and open up while sharing them. When I got a little older, we began doing a family fishing trip organized by my father. It was nice to have that quality time as the three generations and experiencing Gramps in a more laid-back manner. Also recall as a kid being totally mystified that he had two cars, one for home and one for driving to Florida. It makes me laugh thinking about it. I feel like I really saw his softer side in the later years. He will make jokes at family gatherings, and when jokes became hard to tell, the twinkle in his eye would give away his humorous intent. I like thinking about his relationship with the cat, even though he pretended not to care for her much. I cherish the memories I have of him, happy practicing with moves and watching my two-year-old daughter play. He loved us all very, very much. Thank you for helping my family for well during this time and permitting me to share. His youngest granddaughter, Patricia, writes, My grandfather was a quiet man. I never found it uncomfortable. In fact, some of my fondest moments with Gramps are the ones where it was just me and him sitting together, when I could feel his presence more than hear his words. We would sit side by side at family gatherings between meals, conversation, songs, banter. His eyes would follow Paige as she danced around the room, although the cat and dog play, and wonder at the lights on the Christmas tree, take in the freshly planted flowers in June. He didn't have to say anything. I would feel his love and appreciation for it all, even in the silence. I admire Gramps for how diligently you work to build our family. I love him for every hardship he supported us through. And I will miss him terribly for all the milestones you won't be present for. But I know that all the beautiful moments of life will continue to bring, and he will be with us. Grace Pellicano writes, that is his niece. Our mothers were sisters, and we grew up in an extended family household. He gave me rides on the back of his two-wheel bicycle. I chased after him in the streets on a scooter. He taught me how to bite a fish hook and land a catch and prepare it for dinner. He helped paint my apartment and gave me my first set of tools. We shared a love of Sting of Pearls by Glenn Miller and swing music. I welcomed him home from the Korean War, waving a small American flag and proud of him, proud of his uniform, and forever grateful. We shared a home, a family, and a life of a strong values. He was my hero. He called me Cookie. My dear family, at early morning on Thursday, 23rd December, the day after 92 years, 7 months, and 3 days of lifespan, Larry went home to God. I got a great call from his daughter, Linda, as she was overwhelmed by the passing of her dad. She asked me whether I had given the final ride to her dad. And I said, yes, Linda. Not last time when I saw him, the oak tree, but several times at home. She was so relieved that dad was at peace with God and answering himself. My dear family, the words of today's second reading are the most appropriate as we gather in prayer to celebrate Larry's life. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness. Yes, today's Larry's life story passes before us with his fond memories, joys, sorrows, disappointment, and successes. May we all treasure the story of Larry's life and journey and hold it close within our hearts. We give thanks to God for the many ways that Larry has touched and enriched our lives and our joys of faith, journeys of faith. We pray that as we remember him before God, that he too from his place in heaven will remember us. His faith and love, which bound us together over many years, will still bind us in his new life where there will be no more toil, pain, suffering, but rest, but no more fear, but security, no more sadness or weariness, but gladness and joy eternal. People who live a good life never die. And so we pray in this season of Christmas. Merciful God, who gave us the miracle of a new life in Bethlehem, we thank you for the new life you give now to Larry. Our journey during Advent days has brought us with the expectancy to the holy day of Jesus' birth. We bring to you that same anticipation and the same hope to this day and ask now that you bless it with the peace that the world cannot give, and that thanks be to your name, the world cannot take away. In our ears rings a story of a wise man, of shepherds, of new parents, and of a baby. Move our ears now to hear the cross and the empty tomb. A cross that can save us,
an empty tomb that points us towards a good tomorrow. We thank you for the way in which the life of Larry has crossed our paths, and rejoice now his path crosses the way with the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May beloved brother Larry rest in peace. Amen. May soul and souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace.
For those who live a sincere and good life, the hour of death is transformed into hour of glory because Christ gives them the crown of eternal life. Let us pray in our loss, in our hour of loss. After every prayer, let our response be, Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, you washed Rams with the waters of baptism. You anointed him with the oil of the Holy Spirit and nourished him at your table. Give him now a place among your saints and chosen ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
We pray for Rams. May God receive him kindly with generosity and forgiveness and the rewards of his faith. May he continue to inspire us, to intercede for us, and be there at the end to welcome us in our return into eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Rams fought the good fight. He finished the race. May he now receive the crown of eternal glory. Christ won for us through his death and resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
We give thanks for all the life enriching and loving qualities that made Rams such a wonderful gift to all who knew and loved him. Sharpen our awareness of how we can reach out to others like he did. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
We thank God for the gift and privilege of knowing Larry or Gramps, and thank God for the joy and laughter and smiles he brought into our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For all deceased relatives and friends of the Carlucci, the La Serena, the Ork families, including his wife Rosita, Son Lawrence Carlucci Jr., his parents, Grace and John Carlucci. In-laws, Ida and Anthony Glasserino, Herman and Natalie Ork. May they all share in their blessed home with our Savior Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Not on life here.
For the family and friends of Grace, we pray for his daughter Linda and her husband Douglas, daughter-in-law Patricia, his grandchildren Lauren Natalie, Mary Catherine, James Lawrence, Patricia Rose, and their spouses Jeremy, Frank, and Alana, and great-granddaughter Paige Catherine, nephews and nieces, relatives and friends. May they be strengthened by the love they shared. We pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Father, into your hands we commend the soul of our brother Lawrence. Look gently upon him, bring him home to your kingdom, where death will be no more. We are just praying to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Together say one Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners.
I'd like to invite Blessed St. Gibbs. Linda and husband Doug, Theodore and Chloe, Michael Joseph and Kathleen Sulzinski, Oliver Crosby.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings of bread and wine, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Lawrence Carlucci, we ask your mercy that Larry, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For Jesus is the salvation of the world, the life of human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through Jesus, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we all acclaim. So that he may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, gave you thanks and praise, and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, and giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our beloved Pope, John, our bishop, and all the other bishop clergy. Remember, Father, remember your servant, Larry Carlucci, along with his wife, Rosita, his son, Larry, his parents, in-laws, Doug's parents, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Lawrence, who was united with your son, Jesus, in a death-like case, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Have mercy on us all, we pray,
that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Mother of the Church, Lady of Consolation, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, including St. Pius X, our patron saint, St. Agnes, Padre Pio, St. Prince of Calcutta, St. Francis, St. Lawrence, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, who may merit to be coherent eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through the Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever. Amen. Stop and trying to say the words, trying to remember. And he said that prayer. I was very slow, saying one word by one word, and that's what we said the prayer. So this morning, as we celebrate the giving of life, there is a prayer which Larry loved, we all love, because it has come from our loving Savior Jesus Christ. So, people of faith, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity of your kingdom. Believe forever and ever. Amen. My beloved friend, the peace of our loving and compassionate Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Be open to others and peace, peace, peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. And prayerfully we all can say together, Lord, I am not worthy to shed my roof, but only say the word, so shall we. May the body and blood of Jesus Christ bring us to everlasting. Receive your Christ, please come forward.
sacrament of your only begotten Son, Jesus, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory. We humbly implore you, Lord, for your departed servant, Lawrence, that claims by the Paschal mysteries, let him may glory in the gift of the resurrection to come. We ask this prayer to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. My dear family, trusting God, we are together with your dad, your father-in-law, your grandpa, great-grandpa, your uncle, your friend, your cousin. Now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although we will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. This time, we go to incense, his body. Incense, sign of reverence, and our farewell. Our commitment prayers to rise, our beloved Larry, to the throne of God. As I do this, hold on your precious memory, which you have spoken, we hold in our hearts. Let us thank God for his life. Let us pray for him. And let us pray for one another. Namely, we pray for his family. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commit our beloved brother Lawrence in the sure and certain hope that together we all who are died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many blessings which you bestowed upon Larry. They are signs to us of a goodness and of a fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers upon the gates of paradise your servant. Help us remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ in a video. And with our brother Larry forever, we have this prayer to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Larry, may the angels lead you to paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Larry, may the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sunshine warm upon your face, then falls up upon your foes, and until you meet again, may good and gracious God hold you in the palm of his hands. Amen. And finally, Larry, in the rising of the sun and it is going down, Larry, we will remember you. In the blowing of the wind and the chill of winter, we will remember you. In the rustling of leaves and the beauty of autumn, we will remember you. In the opening of birds or rebirth of spring, we will remember you. The beginning of the year, when it ends, Larry will remember you. When we are weary and need of strength, we'll remember you. When we are lost and sick at heart, we'll remember you. When we are joyous, we too shall remember you. So long as we live, you too shall live. Amen. And finally, let's give the big round of applause for this man. That's a wonderful man.